In this demonstration, I'm going to review the basic JMP 11 installation process for an electronic software download order on Windows. I'm going to be using JMP Pro version 11, but this same process works for JMP 11. I'm going to be using a Windows 7 operating system, but unless otherwise noted in your specific installation instructions, these steps can be used for the supported versions of Windows Vista and Windows 8. To view a list of supported operating systems, please see our Systems Requirements page at www.jmp.com. When a new JMP software order is created, a software order email is sent to a person at your site who is referred to as the SAS installation representative. This is what the email looks like. This software order email contains a SAS order number and a SAS installation key. I use these when I download my software. The email also contains information on how much space is needed on my operating system to download the software, my technical support site number, the operating system for which the software is intended, and the product version of JMP software that I'm installing. This software order email shows that this download is for a 64-bit Microsoft Windows environment. Note that the JMP 11 installer can be used on either a 32-bit or a 64-bit operating system. Let me review what we're going to do. First, I'm going to download the SAS Download Manager. The SAS Download Manager is used to download your software orders from SAS into a software depot. Then, I'll use this Download Manager to download the JMP software. Downloading JMP software is not the same as installing it. This step puts the installation media onto my computer. The third step is an optional step for distribution. And, after downloading, the last step of the email shows me where the files are installed on my system. And then, I can follow the instructions to install the software. Okay, so now that we know what we're going to be doing, let me show you the steps. To download the SAS Download Manager, I'll click this link from the SAS Software Order email. I'll choose the latest version of the SAS Download Manager, and then select the correct platform for the SAS Download Manager and click Request Download. I will log into my SAS profile. If you don't already have a profile, you'll need to create one. To do this, click Create. I'll review and agree to the terms, and then click Download to begin the SAS Download Manager installation. Depending on what browser you use, you might have the option to either run or save the file. For this example, select Run to continue. You might see a security warning asking if you want to run this software. Select Run to continue. Let's look at the SAS software order email again for just a minute. I'm now at step 2, which outlines how to download the SAS software using the SAS Download Manager. I'll need to take note of my order number and the SAS installation key, because I'm going to need them to proceed with the download. I'll select my language for the SAS Download Manager, and I'll enter my order number and SAS installation key. I'll click Next. This dialog is more of a verification screen. After checking the order number and the site name, I can optionally add some notes about my order. I don't need to do this for this demonstration, so I'll keep going by clicking Next. On this screen, JMP Technical Support recommends that I select Include Complete Order Contents, so I'll do that and click Next. Now I'll enter the Software Depot directory. By default, the directory name is SAS Software Depot. I can enter an alternative name or location, and if the directory is not yet created, the SAS Download Manager will create it for me. I'm going to just use the defaults. Let me take a minute to review a few of the best practices for SAS Software Depots. The SAS download site limits the number of downloads that may be performed per order. If you need to distribute the software image internally, download it to a networked location that is available to all systems where the software needs to be installed. You can also copy the depot media to a drive such as a DVD or USB drive. Now, back to the download. I'm going to click Yes to continue. I'll review this information and click Download. The download time will vary depending on your network connection. After the download reaches 100%, I'll click Next to continue. Review the information on the next two screens and click Finish. Now I want to take another minute to explain two relevant folders for the jump installation, the jump folder and the SID underscore files folder. The SID underscore files folder contains license files for each type of jump product that have been downloaded. There are separate license files for each operating system and for each major release. The naming convention of the license file shows both the version and the operating system. When installing Jump directly from the SAS software depot, the appropriate license file from this directory will be applied as long as the original depot structure is maintained. Let's go back to the email again and look at step 4. I will open the default location for the Jump installation files. Look for the appropriate product and operating system to find the location of these files. For example, I'm installing Jump Pro on Windows, so I'll open this directory. To begin the Jump installation, I'll run the setup.exe. It is recommended to right-click the setup icon and choose Run as Administrator. For more information on best practices when installing Jump 11 annually licensed software, please visit the link shown on the screen. Thanks for watching!